mother. She's so transfixed by melancholy baby.
I'm in love with you. We'll be melancholy too.
Thank you. Oh, that was great.
Oh, things are finally starting to look up.
Oh, the guy, Melancholy Baby.
Oh, yeah, Melancholy Baby.
Oh,
that was great.
God, I thought he sang it so nice.
I think this is a good group.
Unless I will be melancholy too. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Noel. That was great.
Hollywood, where you're terrific, if you're even good. Where anyone at all, from TV's Lassie to Monroe's Chassie, is equally undisturbed. Go out and try your luck. You might be Donald Duck. Hooray for Hollywood. Hooray for Hollywood, that phony super coney Hollywood. They come from Chillicothe and Paducah's with their bazookas to get their names up in lights, all armed with photos from local rodos, with their hair in ribbons and legs in tights. Hooray for Hollywood. You may be homely in your neighborhood.
We're here for a photo shoot. This is Noel Carroll.
Without Josie is the story of a man in his 80s that is, he's going through the hardest time of his life because he's suffering from the loss of his wife, Josephine. And we basically stay with him for 7 days and watch him go through this mourning period. It's crazy. He gets back home to this empty house and he feels completely lost without his wife, his best friend. And it's just a real touching story about something that we will all go through with marriage and children and life and death. And it's a story about one man's fight to hold on to what he has left, and that's the love for his wife.
It's when reality sets in. And in the film, when I find out that she's really gone, especially when I look at her shoes and I'm putting things away. In that point in the film, I was really touched. I was really touched because I was back in a similar situation. And I think that was one of the most important scenes in the movie.
Noel was absolutely the soul of this movie. He really kept the crew working at their top level, even when we would spend hours upon hours of shooting, and we would shoot some days for 18 hours going until about 4 o'clock in the morning. And just the passion that Noel had really kept my passion high, and also the whole crew. It was because we were so small, and what we were accomplishing with literally six people on set was just incredible.
When Noel Carroll came into the audition, I don't even think he actually knew what the script was about.
No idea at all.
He just walked in there. I handed him a voiceover, and I was just adjusting audio levels and watching him, and he was clearing his throat.
Hi, my name is Noel Carroll, and I'm auditioning for the part of Henry Wabashaw.
And he started speaking, I mean, in this like really cute, you know, Winnie the Pooh type voice.
I had no idea how you landed in this poor dunk town. I thought you must have fallen off your cloud. How was I to know you would become my angel?
And I mean, it was just like magic. I was like, boom, you know, it's like, this is my man. You know, this is the guy I've been waiting for. This whole story is centered around this man, and it all just came to life as soon as Noel opened his mouth.
As soon as I found out what the script was all about, I fell in love with the film. Because right away when I was asked questions in regards to my life and my wife and what the film was all about, that really hit me hard, because it wasn't too long ago that my wife passed away. And it was a similar situation. But then when we actually did the scene on camera, on set, the emotion just swelled up in me, you know, and I was in it. It was like I was reliving something that happened before in my life.
As soon as I saw Noel, it brought so much emotion out of me. And he didn't say maybe four words. It was his voice and the look in his eye. And I had beads of tears welling in my eyes. And I knew this is the guy.
Inside, you were getting into it, and you were believing it.
Yeah. Well, yeah. I guess that's part of acting. Part of acting, you gotta. Well, it's better if you feel a little, then you can act a little better. Which that was good.
No, you did it. You did good. You did good.
Okay. You have the memories, but you can't look back because you have to persevere. You have to continue living.